great and subtle way to personalize your look on the ice is doing something as simple as changing the colors on your skate. Look at how successful Ovi has been with his iconic laces. I can't wait.
Welcome back to EA Sports. Beautiful night for hockey. He's Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Let's get it going tonight. Well, we've been waiting for this one all day long, and here we go. The Scorpions start with possession as we are now underway. Sends the pass over. Takes it right in the chest. Great heads up play to poke it away in the offensive end. Montreal's looking to break out. Slides the puck over. With possession along the wall. Back to the blue line.
Scores!
And they get on the board quickly here in this one.
When we were talking to the coach this morning, he said on the road, this team has a tendency to slumber their way into games. Not today.
Hey, we get a good look at the deflection here. Yeah, I didn't notice that so much in real time, but the shot is in a place where that puck can be deflected, change direction, and beat the goalie.
Still plenty of time left in this frame. Bacon Country's ahead, 1-0. Montreal's got the puck. Angles it over to Devil. Montreal's got it in their own zone. And that slides right out to center ice. Good reach for the stick to knock the puck away. Slides it up front. And that's knocked away in the defensive end by Shockey. Here's a chance! Turned aside with the glove by Ben. There's the whistle as the puck stopper elects to hang on. Still lots of time left here in this frame. Bacon Country's up 1-0. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Moves with the puck to the corner. Montreal's got possession of the puck. Tosses it on to Devil. Grabs control of it at the point. Great reach with the poke check. Oh, just like that, steals the puck and goes the other way.
You're 10 ply, bud.
Control of it once again. Move to the middle. Not happening. Little puck swatted out of the slot. Excellent play by the defender. And look at this. We've got a 2-on-1. They scores. They tie it up. They stay with it the entire time, Ray.
I'm tired of listening to coaches. The process, but the process rated, you keep chipping away and you hope to get to this point.
With his close quarter superstar ability, he got in tight to the crease and put that one in. That's a solid goal, guys.
You're 10 fly, bud.
Montreal's got a hold of it along the wall. Las Vegas has possession of the puck in the offensive end. And that's picked off in front. Moves it to Devil. Up along the wing. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone. From his own end, he moves it up ahead. He's got a step. Move to the middle. I don't know what to describe that as.
I can tell you, whatever he thought was going to happen, it wasn't that. They don't even get a shot.
Montreal's playing it from the side. Catburger-like play with the stick. Nicely done. Here's an offensive chance. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. Breakaway!
Oh, you're not going to get many chances better than this. It's you and the goaltender.
Quick shot! Fantastic save!
These are frustrating. You don't get many chances. passes like this. I thought he made a good shot, but the goalie, an excellent stop, beats the shooter.
All alone! But he can't get it to go!
Looks like an overfake to me, James. You got three things in your head, and you can't quite pick anything, and you end up with no shot on net.
Goes to the crease! Can't get it to go! Slides it diagonally to Gilbert.
Minutes of action here tonight. We've got lots more still to come. Second period is just around the corner. Teams are back at center ice, and we are ready to get period number two underway. Been a fun one so far. Neither side giving an inch. Still tied here as we open things up in the second.
Las Vegas, you're 10, Clyde, bud.
Montreal's got a hold of the puck now.
Lots of bumps and bruises in the course of the game. This one looks like it took a little bite out of him, but I think he's going to try and finish this shift.
Roy's going to hang on to the puck for a whistle.
That one stung, and he's slow to get himself back together here, James. I want to look at that again.
Lots of time left in this period. We got a tie game.
Puck is dropped, and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. He slides it quickly to Gilbert. And that pass attempt is deflected. Moves the puck along the half wall. Las Vegas has it in their own zone. Makes a move, and the puck hops away from him.
Trying just a little bit too much there. Foiled on that play.
And there we go. Icing is the call. We haven't even hit the midway mark of the period. It's all tied up. Las Vegas wins the draw.
Small play, but a key play. Now you've got possession in the offensive zone.
Here's a breakaway! Scores! Whoa!
Wow, this is a great reaction, James. He doesn't have much time to finish it off. Makes a perfect shot. Some guys like to shoot, some guys like to deke. You can shoot the puck like that on a breakaway. I'd pick that as option A.
Montreal's gone in front here in the second. What are you hearing between the benches?
Nobody's really that comfortable. I mean, they're happy, of course, they've got the lead, but this is going to stay close. Can get dangerous if nobody's in control of the puck.
And both centers glide into the dot as a faceoff set to resume. Las Vegas wins the draw. Takes the feed. To his teammate. Gains control of the puck here on the blue line. Grabs the puck in the corner. Bacon Country's got a hold of the puck. Devils moving it ahead. Sends a pass over. Went for the dirty dangle and it goes sideways.
Looks like he's trying to get points for degree of difficulty. You don't have to make a fancy move all the time. That one gets poked away.
Gotcha!
And things starting to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. It's 2-1. Back underway, and they take possession here inside the offensive zone. The 360 with the puck. Grabs it in his own end. Devils carrying it ahead. Montreal's got it now. Roy's going to hang on for a whistle. Here in the late going of the frame, we've got a 2-1 game. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Poked away in the offensive zone by Shockey. Montreal's got it in their own zone. Takes a hit on the play. He got robbed again.
He's got to get his head up here. We're going to be carting him off the ice.
Feeds the puck across to Shockey. 2-on-1. Here's a shot. Misses a golden opportunity there. Look to start the transition game. He might have a step here. Denies him on the breakaway. Ben's going to elect for the faceoff and maybe just a chance to play with the puck a little.
Well, you get to feel it for sure, but he hasn't had much to do at all. His team's been in control as they lead this game.
Both teams readying here for the faceoff. That's a smart read with the two centermen tied up. Bringing an end to period number two. Still 20 minutes more of action in the third. Stick around. Two down, one to go. Third period, they're ready to drop the puck. Bar extra time, the final frame of this one. Here we go, third period is underway. Ray Ferraro is between the benches and ice level. Ray, we've got 40 minutes played so far. How do you view things?
Las Vegas is pretty fortunate this game is close.
Stoppage of play, here comes a penalty shot. Shot. Wow. Completely misses the net on the penalty shot.
The net's been in the same place for 100 years. You gotta hit it.
We're still in the early stages of this period. Bacon Country's got a slim lead. They lead it 2-1. And that's poked away. Montreal's got the puck. Bacon Country's got the puck in the defensive end. Shockey's gonna play it against the half wall. Couldn't complete the pass.
You're 10 ply, bud.
Bacon Country's got a hold of it against the wall. Grabs it. He's got a little jump. He scores! Wow!
Looked like the goalie was expecting a deke. He got back a little deep in the net, and the puck beats him with the shot.
Las Vegas has won the draw, and they take possession in the neutral zone. Rocks them. Montreal's gained possession along the boards. Tried to make a move, and the puck hops away.
Devils tricks up his sleeve, but he tries there to get around the defender. Just can't quite complete the move.
And the puck clears the zone. They'll be forced to leave as well. And offside, we'll get a reset here. Nearing the midway mark of the period. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Las Vegas will go to work as they win the draw. Right up the gut into the attacking zone. He grabs the puck here at the point. Penalty shot coming up after that whistle. And here he comes from center.
Just
a bullseye. He gets the puck back close to the net. He never misses. What a quick shot.
Las Vegas has dictated the flow in this one, and they finally got a lead here in this third period.
It can get frustrating when you have this much possession and no result, but finally they get the lead, and now it's time to bring it home.
Working across to Devil. Looking to make something happen along the boards. Takes it to the front. Can't connect on the pass. Trying to come up with a huge defensive play to get this puck out of his own end. And now he angles it across to Gilbert.
You're 10-5, bud.
On the side by Ben.
Even from this distance, he's not scared about sending that heat seeker into the net. He's looking for a rebound, a chance on goal, a screen, something.
Oh, off the outside of the frame.
Montreal's players are frustrated as they have a really good scoring chance, but it hits the post. And does it close the gap?
Great read with the stick. Puck clears the zone and they'll be forced to regroup. Here's the scoring chance. 2-on-1. Swung away with the stick in the defensive zone. Rocked again.
James, down here it's pretty easy to see that this guy is being targeted. He's got a notice here. He's been hit so many times tonight.
The Scorpions gain possession along the wall. Montreal's got possession at center. Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. Less than 60 seconds left in regulation. Montreal's got it against the boards. Broken up with the stick on the defensive end. From the back of the cage with the puck. Denies that opportunity. Things start to get a little physical out there. Trying to gain a step. He's in all alone. Sends it over. Scores! Clinical!
Because he's carrying the puck in a shooting spot, the goalie still has to guard against whether he's going to deke or not. He freezes him and beats him with the shot.
Late goings of this period. Las Vegas seems to be looking for more after increasing their lead to 2 goals. He says, let's get physical on that play.
Move!
Oh, and the anchor is dropped on that hit. Montreal's playing it through the neutral zone. Shuts him down. And they send it down the ice.
Positioning's perfect. He gets into the butterfly and makes the save.
The centers will glide into the dot. Takes possession of the puck off the draw. And they'll go on the attack after that turnover. And that's all she wrote from this one here tonight. Las Vegas seemed to simply dictate the flow of the game all night long, Razor.
There's not really an area where they struggled. Started in the face-off circle, I thought they moved the puck well. They skated well, and they deserved the victory.
Welcome back, everyone. It's Carlin Baith here in the world of Chell. I love how active this community has been on social media, posting game highlights, customized kit designs, and really promoting the game of hockey. It's so great to be part of this.
Oh.
you're a lone wolf out here in the world of Chell, why not try playing some drop-in games to find new teammates? It's a great way to meet other competitors and a fun way to make new friends. And some squad mates you can invite to your own club. Welcome back, and what a moment I just witnessed. An incredible breakaway goal with a few dangles and a celly made famous by number 68. For those about to score, I salute you.
In the air for this one. Hi, everybody. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski from EA Sports. You ready for a game tonight? Really looking forward to this one tonight. And this one is officially underway with the puck drop.
Gotcha!
Take control of it.
Get wrecked!
Starts a ramp up here after that hit. Great reach with the poke check. Moves it quickly over to Stoner. Fires it into the offensive zone. Puck moved over to Tucker. Oh, look at this chance!
The goalie when you have to stop the shot. This thing's like a rubber ball. It's bouncing all over the place and somehow ends up behind the goalie. That's a tough break for him.
Canada's won it. And a stiff break set up. Poked away and forces the turnover at center. And he's going after him here.
Gary's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else.
Here's a short pass to Cronwall. He looks deep to Tucker. Los Angeles gains a hold of it. That pass doesn't go. And that play's broken up.
Los Angeles has turned the middle of the ice into a mud pot. Every time the puck's moved, he seemed to be in position to intercept it and head the other way.
And that's broken up.
Here, what a solid body check delivered there. He's known for this, and he doesn't miss this opportunity.
Still lots of time left in the period. Los Angeles leads it 1-0. Stoner's won the draw here in the open ice.
Got him.
Trying to engage a little physical.
Get wrecked.
Oh, hello. What a collision.
Now, that's not a collision. That's one player delivering a solid body check to another. He's known for this. If you have your head down for just a second, look out.
Some last second communication before both teams get ready to drop the puck here. Stoner's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. And that's poked away in the offensive zone by Keel. Receives the pass. Fires it into the offensive zone. The Kings have it now. Broken up at center by Tucker. And here at center, that's intercepted. And skilled use of the stick to poke the puck away. Made that stop. Right in front. Turns it aside with the glove. In front, and a stoppage on the play as the goaltender covers things up. Past the halfway mark of this period, 1-0 is where we sit at this point. Nice job tying up his opponent. We've got icing on the play. Faceoff coming up. They take possession as he locks them up off the faceoff. Wow, deja vu.
Man, they got to keep their heads up for this guy. He has been all over the ice. He's been all... There's going to be a penalty on this play here, James.
Let's get the call.
An ill-advised penalty, a bad time. One goal down, and now your penalty killers have to keep you right there.
Well, as both teams dig in for the face-off here, just moments away, it's our first opportunity to look at the power play unit here.
First chance of the night for the power play. The guys are pretty excited to get out there and see if they can get on the board.
Handles the puck.
Keel's dangerous in the offensive zone. He's got it now, and he's already got the go-ahead goal.
Canada's got the puck along the boards. And that was read perfectly. What a play by Gary. Los Angeles has it in the open ice. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go.
doesn't want anything to do with him.
Time is of the essence for this 5-on-3 power play.
On a 5-on-3 as short as this, there's likely a set play off the faceoff to try and get a quick shot.
Quick feed to Keel. Matthews asserts his time in the box, but they remain shorthanded. And that doesn't exactly go take to take. Oh, he comes up with a stop as he got the glove on it.
Goalies love the butterfly. They know they've got a lot of the net covered, so he slides across. Doesn't worry about this shot.
Sends it across.
Whoa. Offensive zone, he's robbing the one-timer, and he does not miss. We watch him do this time and again at practice. Of course, there's no goalies in there, because who wants to volunteer for this? But this is a missile. The one-timer blows right by the goaltender.
Just here in the late stages of this frame, Los Angeles continues to lead by a pair of goals. Moves it up through the middle for the right, and puts the body into it, a little play for car hockey.
Get wrecked!
A little knock on the play. Some solid defensive work in their own end with the poke check. Takes the feed in the middle of the neutral zone. Reads it perfectly and comes up with the takeaway.
That's the right time to try something. I mean, you want to spark a play that maybe can create some offense.
Quick pass to Gary. There's the whistle. We get a face-off after the goalie covers up. Some last-second communication with the D as centers get ready to drop the puck. Swoops in off the wing to grab the puck after the centerman tied him up. Here's the pass! And a stick in the lane deflects that one away. And he hangs on just as time runs out. There's the horn. Still 40 more minutes left in regulation time. We'll get to the second period right after this. Teams back on the ice after the first intermission. Ray Ferraro, James Cebulski ready to bring in the call for period number two. Here we go, middle frame now underway as the puck drops. Well, we've got over 20 minutes played thus far. Ray, how have you seen things?
Los Angeles can't help but be pleased with that first period. The two-goal lead is awesome, but it's the way they played, and I'm sure the coaches are thrilled with that.
Still plenty of time left in this frame, and it's a 2-0 hockey game. Clockworks won the draw. Matthews carries the puck in his own zone. Los Angeles
wrecked.
Going down with the puck.
I'm sorry for stepping on your toes, James, but that was a huge hit as the play continues.
Takes the feed. Centering pass. And that one's blocked. And now it's grabbed by Cronwall. And no luck on that pass attempt. Great chance. Rough around in front. Los Angeles has it behind the net. And just a good old-fashioned solid body check on the play. Penalty coming up as the play's blown dead.
As he's trying to defend, he just wants his stick on the puck, but he gets it into the other guy's feet, and the tripping penalty is called.
And a man advantage unit comes out to go to work. Clockworks got it, and they're on the attack.
He scores! Well, they've been hoping that the extra work being done on the power play would help them capitalize. They do a nice job there. He's in the bumper position in the middle of the slot. They move the puck around to find him in the middle, and he makes no mistake.
Officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another faceoff here. Return pass, and they turn it over in the neutral zone. Moves the puck down low, and that's a smart heads-up play by Matthews. Moves it to Cronwall. Moved up ahead here in the neutral zone. Canada's got a hold of it along the wall. Denies him on the play.
We see goaltenders in this butterfly prop.
He might have a step here. He scores!
Here's the one-on-one game. The goalie thinks he's going to deke, but he beats him with a quick shot.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. We got a tie game. Puck scooped up by Cronwall. Looks to pass it to Gary.
Get wrecked!
This has to seem like rush hour to him. He can't get from one end of the ice to the other without getting run over.
And things starting to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. And the puck skips away after that move.
Sometimes trying a little bit too much is just no good for anybody. That play gets broken up.
There's the whistle icing the call. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone.
After the icing, there's a little more pressure on the centerman to win the draw.
Gets the puck in deep. Moves it quickly over to Keel. Couldn't catch up to that pass. And that's off a stick. Oh, textbook quick check to turn that over. Here's a short pass to Tucker. And that one's broken up by a great defensive play. LaRiviere's going to give everyone a chance to breathe and hang on to the puck.
Gilbert's physical presence is something that can change the course of the game, guys. With a solid body check, he can cause some separation and force those turnovers. That's his truculent zone ability, and it's how he likes to intimidate his opponents.
Poked away at center by Matthews. Takes a hit on the play. Denies him in close. And the puck clears the zone.
Gotcha!
Yay!
Wrecked!
Yeah, that wasn't just going to run somebody out of the play. He's known for this. If he's got an opportunity to blow somebody up, he's going to do it. That was a big hit.
And that pass is redirected. There's a hit on the play. Quick feed to Gary. He's got a step. A chance in front. And I'm not quite sure what the hope was on that.
James, you said it. He was in all alone. Now he's going to skate out all alone because he doesn't get anything.
Scores! Are you not entertained?
Shows a fair bit of truculence right there. Runs over the puck carrier. Now he's created separation, and the play turns over. He gets an assist as they end up scoring the goal.
In the final moments of this period, Clockwork's got a one-goal lead. At center ice now, he grabs the puck, and he moves it up to Tucker. Moves the puck over to Stoner, and that's picked off. Things starting to get a little physical out there. Great defensive effort breaking up the pass. And that's poked away by Cronwall. Feeds the puck over to Stoner.
Wow, did you get the speed gun out for that one there, Ray?
Nah, didn't get it out in time, and that's a heck of an effort by him to go all that way to keep the play alive. No ice.
Get wrecked!
Calling him out now.
Cronwall's turning this challenge down. That's not part of his game.
Oh, what a collision with that hit.
Known for this, he doesn't make any mistake. There's the opportunity to lay a body check out, and he's right on it.
Los Angeles is ready to go back to work on special teams. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Trying to get it out of their own end. And he easily stops that one.
That is sweeping up the trash there. Good save. Off to the corner. Everybody can readjust.
He almost lost it for a second.
Evisceration!
Nice pass. And with the seconds to spare, they get a goal here to close things out.
You gotta look at it from both ways. That's a real kick in the pants for the team that gave up the goal. But what a boost of energy for them to score this late in the period.
This is exactly what we've talked about, guys. His ability to muscle opponents off the puck. It doesn't matter if he gets on his score sheet or not. When he uses that touch his teammates will carry the load and put it in the back of the net. But it all starts with that hit.
And there's the horn, bringing the second period to an end. All right, they say three is the magic number. Period number three is coming up next. He's Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski, and we are ready to get this third period going. It's been a throwback to 80s hockey here, and we are underway here in the third. Oh, man, he got hit again.
Man, he must feel like a pinata out there. He's been on his backside a half a dozen or more times tonight.
The slide! He tries to tuck it in! He scores! That's the hat trick!
Now, what a great in the game. Doing it on the road is a real nice trick. I think the goalie reads this pretty quickly. He just can't get over there quick enough. Outstanding move to recognize there's room to wrap this in.
We're still in the early stages of this period. Los Angeles leads by one. Moves the puck. And he uses his reach to disrupt the play. And now it's over to Keel. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. And they'll go the other way with it. Great play by Cromwell. Oh, wow. That had some hot sauce on that collision.
Did it ever, James. I mean, you could see he was raring to get a hit in to try and change a little bit.
Get wrecked.
Shoulder went into the player. That's a solid, clean hit.
With a front. Off a stick and they can't connect. Clockwork's got a hold of the puck now. Takes the feed up ahead.
Hey, James, who's going to circle back to that last hit? That was an enormous contact.
And that's intercepted, and they'll go on the attack. Here's a shot. Phenomenal save with the glove to knock it away.
Slides across to the butterfly to make the save, but you still have to be agile, even though you're covering the bottom of the net.
Passes right to the front, and that's broken up. Los Angeles has possession of the puck. Has some nice footwork to free the puck up to his teammate. Steps into all that. Nice poke check. Clockwork's moving it up the ice. Now into the offensive zone from the right side. Poked away at center ice. Puck grab by Tucker. Can't complete the pass as it goes off a stick. Pass.
Get wrecked!
With the hit. Clockwork's got the puck in their own end. Canada's got it along the wall. And that's knocked away by Cronwall. Couldn't make that one happen. And they won't connect on that one. On a tee and misses.
Digging into the offensive zone. He's looking for that one-timer no matter where the puck is. This one he hammers and it's off target.
And now he moves it to Tucker. Intercepted. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Gary. Clockwork's got the puck inside the defensive zone.
And now he tries to get it across to Matthews. Blocked in traffic.
Grinding on this game. They want to get this team back to even, but that shot off the post won't help them.
And the intensity starts to ramp up here after that hit. Here's the clearing attempt, and that's a big clear at this stage of the game.
Yeah, they're all big now. That puck's near the blue line. It's got to get out.
Takes the pass. Gilbert's lugging the puck. Icing is the call. We'll get a reset. Getting into the later stages of this period, it's a one-goal game here. 4-3 is where we sit. Center's jammed up, and the winger grabs the puck. The Kings take over on possession. Along the half wall with the puck. From the point, looks to make something happen. On the wraparound! Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. And it's whoa, across to Cronwall. There's another for the hit parade. And there's a power play opportunity coming up here. Grabs the puck. Up the neutral zone now. And there's the whistle stopping the play.
Well, this puts a lot of pressure on the penalty killers, but they can seal the deal here with a...
puts their hard hats on as they go back to work. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. A chance to get it out. Big defensive play on that clear.
That puck's got to get out, especially late. He does a nice job here.
Trying to engage a little physicality here. Oh, DeNison with the paddle save. There's the whistle. Let's get the call for the officials.
I never killed penalties, I tell you. Sitting on the bench watching the penalty killers, that clock goes slow.
A critical face-off looms here with the empty net.
When the goalie's out, this face-off is all important. Win the draw, have a chance.
The Kings win the draw.
Got him.
He got all that hit. And they clear that puck. Canada's got the puck along the wall. Sends the pass over. Centering pass. Takes the puck at the point. Picked up along the boards by Johnson. His reflexes on display tonight. There's the horn, and that's the hockey game.
Well, the special teams did have a big factor in the way this played out, James. The better power play turned out to be for the winning team.
No shortage of opportunities, though, for either side.
Yeah, both had the same. One power play executed better.
Looking to brush up on some individual skills? Well, you can put effort into both offense and defense by playing some games of ones. It's three skaters and a goalie battling it out for the ultimate bragging rights. It's definitely worth the challenge.
lines are lined up, and we are set to get things going. There's been a healthy buzz for this one. Now it's time to see if it lives up to the hype. And we'll reset things after that icing. Lots of time left in this period. Still no score in this one. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Slides the puck over. Scooped up along the wall by Matthews. From the board, he takes that pass. Too much congestion in front. And that pass goes off a stick. Oh!
For that one.
Handles the pass from the right side. And that one's broken up. Los Angeles steps inside. Sends it over. Scores! What's he gonna do?
Great example here of close quarter zone ability, James. In tight, you have to still deliver that puck accurately. It's done to perfection.
Puck is dropped and we are back underway. And that's intercepted on the defensive end. Oh, he gets leveled. You can see this one coming.
Some players love to score goals. He loves to deliver big hits.
He was locked in there.
Yeah, sending a message early there, James. He gets the body contact.
Gotcha!
Oh, a whole lot of truculence with that.
That hit was delivered with intent. That's not to rub somebody out of the play. That's to send a message.
Here's a chance! And too much traffic in front blocks that one. Trying to shake the defender. All alone! Moves the puck behind the net. Los Angeles takes hold of the puck.
This one-timer, he gets enough room to powder this thing, and it's in the net. When his team gets into the offensive zone, they're looking for him because he can do this almost as well as anybody in the game. That one-timer, the pass is on the tape. It's off the tape in an instant.
And that pass can't connect. The Kings move the puck in the defensive zone. Pucked away in the defensive end. Stick. Dishes it to Matthews. Gets the full use of his stick. It's in the back of the net.
Bang, bang. Two goals and right around a minute 40.
Conversely, deflating for the other team.
And that is a kick in the shins right there. They just couldn't stop the bleeding. He didn't waste any time. If he would have stopped that puck, the goalie would have had time to readjust. As it is, it's in the net.
Canada's offense has given them a one-goal lead, not to be Captain Obvious here, Ray, but this is what the coach wants to see, right?
Loves playing in front of the game, and you want to make the opponent chase you around the ice. They've accomplished that with the go-ahead goal.
Past the midway mark of the frame, James and Ray with you tonight. Canada's got the momentum with a one-goal lead. They'd love to add to that. Taken by Gary. Oh, what a little stick lift on the play and comes up with the puck. Slides the puck over to Tucker. The Kings will play from the defensive zone. And that's knocked away by Tucker. Oh, and he wins on it. Great reach with the poke check. Down the right side and into the zone. And he takes a shot. He scores!
Sometimes it's just your night. He's got his second goal of the game. Is a good evening for him. James, there's not a handful of guys in the league that can do this. One time this puck with the velocity and accuracy that he does. They get into the offensive zone, their team's looking for him.
And that's broken up by Tucker. Here's a shot. Wickets, he scores! It looked like he had made the save, but that's in the back of the net for a goal.
I'm not sure how that got into the net. That thing's bouncing all over the place. Not even really a shot.
defense are set. They're ready to drop the puck. Stoner's won the draw here in the neutral zone. And that play's broken up. Moves aside! Scores! The captain comes through! Clockwork's got a hold of the puck off the draw. Connects with a long feed pass here in the middle. A shot! Big time stop there!
Gotcha!
Right on the doorstep! Oh, absolutely hammersome! Hammersome with a big hit!
Well, he got right into him. Solid hit.
Late goings of this period. Canada's now up by 4. Start winning the draw here inside the offensive zone.
After the icing, now you've got the puck again. You can wear them down quickly.
Kiel's got the puck. We got a penalty coming up here on the play. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
Well, it didn't leave the refs much choice on that one, did he, James? That's a penalty no matter how you look at it.
As they step into the face-off circle, let's see if they can take advantage on this power play.
Power play and penalty kill go a long way to determining what your team's going to be like. This is the power play's first chance. We'll see if they can get on the board.
Here he is, tries to turn it in! And that's turned aside.
Yeah, he gets out on top.
Gotcha!
There's really nowhere for that puck to go.
And they get that puck down the ice. Clockwork's got the puck against the half wall. A simple save by LaRivière. Picked up along the wall by Matthews. Quick pass to Stoner.
Got him.
And puts the body into it, a little bumper car hockey. Puck cleared from the defensive end. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Oh, that's got the crowd buzzing after that stop.
I like the way he tracks the puck here. He's got to find it, and then he gets his body right in front of it. That's a good save.
And now he angles it across to Stoner. Forces the turnover in the defensive zone. And that's deflected. And puts it anywhere but the way he wanted it to go.
You kick yourself and
break away. Big stop just as time expires in the period. There's the buzzer. Fans seem to enjoy that first 20 minutes. We'll get to the second period right after both teams get a chance to catch their breath. Stick around. Second period set to get underway. A one-sided affair after the first 20 minutes. Here we go for period number 2. Well, this one underway. Ray, give us an update of what your assessment is to this point.
Los Angeles has to look at the way this game's been played so far and realize they've got way more to give. They're not going to get back in this game playing like this.
Oh, getting a little cheeky there.
Gilbert's not so sure about the weight class here. He says no thanks. Stoner's leadership is often by example, not so much with some great speech in the locker room. They need action now. They've got to get back in this game, and the captain's going to have to lead them to it.
They've got some momentum here. Good look, not a good result, though.
Gotcha!
Clearly doesn't like that.
Stoner's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off. Everybody's trying to work their way through this, but everybody seems to be making the wrong decision out there. This night is not going very well.
Clockworks man advantage unit will take to the ice for the first time tonight.
A criticism of their power play is that they hold the puck, they pass it around a lot, it looks great, but they never shoot it. They'll be trying to get the puck to the net more frequently.
LaRivière has opted to hang on to the puck for a faceoff. Kiltz recognizing they're still shorthanded here as they get ready for the faceoff. Clockwork scattered in the offensive zone. Los Angeles will try to kill a few seconds off this penalty. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Handles the bend pass from along the boards. Tucker's been tripped up, and we got a penalty coming up here. Play is stopped, and here's the official call.
Hey, you come out, you're excited, you got good intentions, but man, it's so balled the wrong way against these guys tonight.
Clockwork's got a 5-on-3 and lots of time on their side.
That is quite some time on the 5-on-3. What a big advantage for them. They have to take advantage of this opportunity. You can't let a two-man advantage slip away.
Trying to get something going here with this man advantage as they start from their own end. Trying to clear. And a nice job by the Killers on that one.
Yeah, now they can get a change, get some fresh players on the ice.
There's the whistle as things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck.
Just moments away from the resumption of this power play. They're ready to drop the puck here for this faceoff. Canada's got possession here in their own end. Moves it to Tucker. Stoner's out of the box, but they're still shorthanded as he steps in to help try to kill off this penalty. Two-man advantage.
Quick puck movement is the way to move these defenders around. If you move it slowly, they're just going to stay in the middle and there's no chances.
Los Angeles. Puck picked up by Matthews. Puck hops out of the offensive zone. They'll be forced to do it over from center.
Gotcha.
Well, get a response.
Stoner's looking around for somebody to fight. He's going to have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else. Quality chance, high quality save.
He took a pretty good jolt there, James, and I think we should take another look. He seems a little shaken up.
Tucker's ready for the draw as we get set to resume this power play. Canada's won the draw. They'll go to work. Grabbed along the board by Matthews. Slides the puck down low. Great defensive effort with the stick. Huge hit.
Yeah, he's done this a lot tonight, James. He's been on the body from the first time he's been on the ice.
And that puck leaves the zone. And now it's grabbed by Tucker.
I don't believe the coaches are going to be too worried about this. They didn't score on the power play. But I think it's most important that they didn't give anything up. They've got such a nice lead. The coaches are more focused on making sure this game plays out comfortably.
Throws it in. Clockworks looking to break out of their own end. And they get the puck out of the danger zone. And a poke check knocks the puck away. Trying to get out of the defensive end. And clearing attempt is a big success on that play. Gary's got it in the defensive end. Slides the puck out of the offensive zone. Feeds the puck up to Tucker. Couldn't complete the pass. Across the line.
Got him.
And serves up a little knock on the play. Takes the feed. And he scores.
When you get into this position, that puck's got to be off your stick in a hurry. You don't have much time to think about it.
Canada's offensive surge continues here in the second.
This is a tidal wave. They have swept right over top of them tonight. It's not even close.
Got him.
And he doesn't miss this opportunity.
Clockworks looking to break out. Trying to get the puck out of his own end. And they get the job done. Los Angeles gains a hold of the puck against the boards. The Kings will play it in their own end. And they get the puck out of the defensive end. Los Angeles looks to get things going now with the puck.
Collision. That's one player delivering a solid body check to another. He's known for this. If you have your head down for just a second, look out.
And just a good old-fashioned solid body check on the play. Puck scooped up by Geary. Canada's got possession here in the neutral zone. Right to the middle. And that one's broken up. Oh, there was some TNT with that collision there.
Yeah, that wasn't just going to rub somebody out of the play. He's known for this. If he's got an opportunity
gotcha.
To rub somebody out, he's going to do it. That was a big hit.
And that's just out of reach. And less than a minute to go here in the middle frame. Puck grab by Cronwall. They've got numbers. And things start to ramp up a little bit now on the ice with that play. Wrap for period number two. Both teams will get a chance to get a little breather here, and we'll come back. Third period action next. For period number three is ready to go. Third period underway here. This has been a total squash to this point. Once again, I'll send it back down to my broadcast partner, Ray, who is at ringside. Ray, we've got two periods played. How do you see this thing?
Los Angeles.
Get wrecked!
The way that they've gone about this game so far. They've done nothing but chase the puck for two periods, and they're losing because of it.
And we're moments away from getting back underway here with the puck drop. They take possession as he locks him up off the faceoff. Canada's got a hold of it along the wall. Here we go. It's a 2-on-1. He got all of that one.
Yeah, and it was that guy who's picking himself and his stick up off the ice.
Big hit on the play.
He's not missed many of these. Every time he gets the puck, he seems to target him, and he's not been able to elude anybody.
Scrum along the boards. Here's a shot! Denies him! He got all of it! And the goaltender grabs that one for a whistle to try to slow things down here. Tucker's won it off the faceoff. And that pass attempt is deflected. Moves it to Matthews. Can't get it to go. Taken along the wall by Tucker. Inside his own end, moves the puck. Moves it quickly over to Tucker. Sends it up right in front. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Clockworks regain possession of the puck.
Evisceration!
Mistake. There's the opportunity to lay a body check out,
and he's right on it.
Clockwork's got the puck. Strong feed from along the boards. Stops him cold. Play blown dead. Let's get the call.
This is always a fine line penalty. You're allowed a little interference, just not that much.
Face off and another opportunity to take a look at the man advantage unit here.
When you're on the power play and you get one in a game you haven't had many, don't let the coach think. Get yourself on the ice and get yourself ready for the faceoff.
Nice job to escape the zone. Great use of the stick at center by Tucker. The Kings have it against the wall. Oh, set that hit up perfectly. Clockwork stopped the puck shorthanded. They'll want to clear the zone here while they're trying to kill off this penalty. They get it out of the defensive end. Violent collision.
He moved in quickly. If you go at that pace, you take away all the available ice.
Picked up along the boards by Tucker. Oh boy, here's trouble. 2-on-1. He scores!
On a power play comes through. They move the puck nicely, and they're able to capitalize on the extra man. Oh, the penalty killers make a mistake. They give up a man advantage.
Sneaks away. Oh, wow. That had some hot sauce on that collision.
Did it ever, James. I mean, you could see he was raring to get a hit in to try and change a little bit of the momentum, and the shoulder went into the player. That's a solid, clean hit.
Los Angeles wins the draw in the neutral zone. Unable to reach that one. And there we go. Icing is the call. Play set to resume with the face-off ready to go. Swoops in off the wing to grab the puck after the centerman tied him up. Here's a chance right in front, and they can't convert on the play. And he denied that opportunity. Denies him again.
Get wrecked!
The teeth for most of this offensive explosion. They're winning by a pile, and he hasn't had much to do.
Pulverizing hit. He got all of that one.
That's going to feel to more than he was in a car crash today.
That was a 9 on the Richter scale. And uses the length of his stick to knock that puck away. And that plays off. Oh, he ripped that right after the whistle.
What's he thinking?
And look at this coming out of his crease to challenge.
Everybody wants to see the goalie go all the way down the challenge. It never happens. But Riviere's ready to go. Apparently,
he's looking for a dance partner.
Yeah, he looks like he wants somebody, anybody to engage with.
The Kings win it. Taken by Cornwall. Intercepted the pass. Sends a pass over. Grabs control at the point. Canada's got the puck. And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Scooped up along the wall by Tucker. We've got icing on the play. Face-off coming up. Look at this, pushing and shoving.
Yeah, it got heated up pretty quickly.
Canada's got a hold of the puck.
That win will help them get organized defensively.
Oh, and there's a great save by Wong! Puck picked up by Tucker. And they'll get it out of the defensive end. Referee signals penalty coming up here with a delayed call. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
That's a frustrated player-tainted penalty right there. There's nothing that has gone their way this evening.
Clockwork's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
I like this. They got together right before the faceoff and discussed a couple of options. They haven't had a lot of opportunities tonight.
And a challenge being thrown down here.
Yeah, that came out of nowhere a little bit, and the challenge is down.
Los Angeles with possession in their own zone. Great use of the stick here at center ice.
Gotcha!
He's calling him out now.
Gary's done everything here except pull the other guy's gloves off.
Trying to exit the defensive zone, and they do just that.
I thought they did a pretty good job there, James. That's a time you can get yourself running around in the zone. They didn't get there.
Quick pass across to Matthews. With authority again.
Again and again. How does he not notice? Get the puck. Move the puck. Get your head up.
Get wrecked.
A few seconds off this penalty now. Canada's grab a hold of the puck. Play is called for offside.
He took a pretty solid jolt there, James. We're going to have
some pushing and shoving here, heating up.
Yeah, the few words lead to a little bit more, it looks like.
Canada's won the draw. Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Aaron pass, and they can't connect.
Stoner's up at the box.
And he regains control of the puck. Clockworks gain possession.
It doesn't really matter that the power play didn't score. They've got such a nice lead. But I'll tell you, as a guy that made a living on the power play, I wanted to score every time I was out there.
An all-out sprint and icing is waved off.
Now the officials looking at both players to see who can get to the top of the circle first where they blow the icing at the hockey.
Get wrecked!
That was a great effort.
Gives up the body in order to block the shot. This one seemed to be controlled right from the faceoff surface.
Well, the strength of their team is up the middle of the ice, James. They're tough to match up against. They're all really good on the draw. They had the puck a lot. All starts from when it hits the ice.
stops on both blue lines here, and we are about set to drop the puck here at center. Been fired up for this one. The puck is dropped. Let's go. Handles the pass from the right wing. Oh, getting a little cheeky there.
Perron's not so sure about the weight class here. He says no thanks.
Still early on in this frame. James and Ray with you. So glad you could join us. Still no score in this one. Slides in off the wing after the centerman tied him up. Way too much congestion blocks that. Clockwork's got it now.
Crushing it.
Scores! Are you not entertained?
The rebound snapped away. What a nice shot. But the goalie's got to do a better job cleaning up that rebound. You can't leave it right there.
Take possession with the two centermen tied up. And they send it right back to him. Perron's tripped up and the official's hand is in the air, signaling penalty. Time for the official to pass down his sentence.
Oh, you can see the frustration right away, James. Shorthanded now and only a one-goal lead.
And the man advantage unit comes out to go to work.
Great opportunity to get this game back to level. A power play, trailing by one. This is a huge opportunity.
From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play. Slides the puck to Perron. Perron's got it along the wing. Here's a short pass to Jacquizzi. Roy's going to cover it up for a faceoff.
While his team's ahead, he wants to make sure the pace of the game stays at the level they like.
Perron's at the faceoff dot, ready to win this draw on the man advantage. Clockworks won the draw. Canada's got it in their own zone. And they get the puck out. Marchand's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. Here comes the call for the official.
Well, the water gets hot pretty quickly here. The penalty killers have to do the job to protect this one-goal lead.
They'll get set to go to work with a 5-on-3.
What a great opportunity with a two-man advantage here. Move the puck quickly, shoot it, make those defenders have to scramble.
And they send it down the ice. Quick feed to Jacquizzi. Into the attacking area from the left side. Quick pass to Jacquizzi. Canada's got it behind the net. Matthews is out of the box, and they'll try to continue to kill off this penalty. Handles it along the blue line. And the traffic neutralizes that threat. Pucks it away in his own end. Here inside the defensive zone, they get the puck. Right in the slot! And a stick break setup. Broken up with a stick in the defensive zone.
Tucker's ready to go.
They fail to capitalize on the man advantage, and they still trail by a goal.
That's a missed opportunity, isn't it? A chance to tie. They don't cash in, and now we're back to 5-on-5.
Graham Prairie's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Knocked away from the stick by Matthews. Centering pass, and they can't connect. And sends it just out of reach. Clockwork's got the puck along the wall. Receives the pass. Unloads from the blue line. Made the stop on the play. On the doorstep.
Wow.
He scores!
Now you gotta keep clawing back. Trailing in the game, they get the equalizer. That's a scorer's goal right there. That puck is on and off his stick in a hurry. He's so tight to the net, he has to get rid of it before the goalie can readjust.
Nice job tying up his opponent. Can't connect on the pass. Moves it to Jacquizzi. What a save! He'll probably feel that one tomorrow. The Flyers gain possession of the puck here in the offensive end. Setting Picked up along the wall by Marchand. Moves it quickly over to Perron. Canada's got a hold of the puck. Looking to clear the defensive zone. And the puck's out of harm's way.
This game has been tight. Now something's got a leg up. Really tough for the goalie to read where the heck this thing's going. I'm looking at the shot. I can't tell where it's going, but the backhander beats the goaltender.
Past the halfway mark of this period, Canada's got a one-goal lead. Off the trot, he ties up his opponent. Here's a short pass to Matthews. Clockworks got the puck against the boards. There's a shot up to the challenge as he gets his pad on it. There's the whistle as the puck is frozen up. Centers glide into the dot as the faceoff ready to resume play. Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. And that somehow stayed out of the net.
Good save. Positional save through traffic.
And now it's grabbed by Tucker. And that's hooked away. Canada's got control of the puck. They try to maintain possession inside the defensive zone. Here's a chance right in the slot. And they come up empty-handed. Keeps holding the puck. Aaron pass and the play's broken up. Here's a chance to set up now. And a great save. Quick feed down low. Great chance in front. Makes the hook stop. Roy's on top of that one for a whistle.
Little bit of traffic starting to form around the net.
Getting into the later stages of this period. Clock works up 2-1 and the crowd has been enjoying this one. And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. And no luck on that pass attempt. Grabbed along the board by Marchand. Canada's got a hold of it against the wall. And that doesn't exactly go tape to tape. Grabs the puck at center. Wow, completely ignored the whistle there.
Jacquezzi's looking around for somebody to fight.
And stirring the pot.
Yeah, a little friction, and all of a sudden, guys are getting heated. Jacquezzi's not interested in dropping the mitts and going at it.
Grand Prairie's won the draw in the neutral zone. Long reach breaks up the momentum. Good pass over to Jacquezzi. Harrell's taking it from his own end. And that concludes the first 20 minutes of play. Second period action. Stick around. Face-off for period number two, about set to go. Well, after an intriguing opening period, here we go. It's period number two. Puck is dropped and we are underway. That pass doesn't go. There's the whistle icing the call. Lots of hockey left to be played in this period. It's a 2-1 game. Canada's won the faceoff.
The icing would have worn them down. That's a big faceoff win for them.
Passes it to Perron. Tried to connect the pass, but it doesn't go. Grand Prairie's got the puck along the boards. intercepted. Dumps it in. The Flyers have it behind the cage. Quick feed to Perron. Clockworth's got the puck in their own end. Taken by Matthews. Handles the puck. And they won't connect on that one. Taken along the wall by Marchand. Dished on over to Chiquisi. Drives to the sweet spot. Denied that one. Big play inside the defensive zone. Grand Prairie's got control of it now here in the offensive end. Let's it rip. And that's turned aside. Bone wide.
This is a good save, and the goalie's got to be sharp because we got one timer set up.
She scores! Oh, that is a goal scorer's goal.
You can't leave her free in close quarters. She just doesn't miss from there. Head up. Great shot. It's on the board. She's got this innate ability to get in tight and deliver the puck accurately. That's not easy to do, but that's what she's known for.
Getting closer to the halfway point of this frame. It's all tied up. Clockworks on the attack. Grand Prairie's got the puck. Sends the pass down low. Can't find his man. Takes the feed. Takes a shot. Glove save by the goalie. And is he up? Oh, he ripped that right after the whistle.
What's he thinking? Perron's ready to go. Apparently, the other guy doesn't want anything to do with him. Just as one guy wants to fight, you don't have to. He says no way.
Centers are set. Faceoff ready to resume play. That's a smart read with the two centermen tied up. Right out front. Can't connect. Perron's got it into offensive territory. Official whistle blown, stopping the play. Gilbert's gonna serve a pair for interference. Grand Prairie's power play unit puts their hard hats on as they go back to work.
You can really only drop the power play so many times. The key is don't lose your confidence in it when it doesn't succeed. Just get right back to the basics of getting the puck to the net and people there at the same time.
Tries to feed it over to Chiquisi. From center, they get into the attacking area. Quick pass to Chiquisi. Oh, and he whiffs. Trying to clear. And they get it down.
That good communication. They talk to each other. They're in the right spot. They just clear it down the ice.
We got a whistle offside the call. Hurrah's ready for the draw as we get set to resume this power play. Canada's won the draw. They take possession here in the open ice. And the puck clears the zone. Nice pass. Penalty coming up here. Matthews is caught for the trip. And he's going on a trip to the penalty box. Grand Prairie's got a small window with a 5-on-3.
This 5-on-3 is critical, even though it's a short one. Get yourself set up and quickly get the puck to the net and move those defensemen around.
And there's the whistle as he elects to slow things down a little.
A pretty good decision here with the play starting to break down in front of him.
Perron's looking to win this draw and this man advantage here.
10 seconds.
Grand Prairie's won the draw and they'll go to work. And they score!
Supposed to work. I mean, it doesn't always work like this, but they looked like they had a real sure idea about what they wanted to get accomplished on this power play. The man advantage comes through, and they've now taken the lead.
Grand Prairie's finally gone in front. What's the approach now, Ray?
Shouldn't change. I mean, the game's not going to spread out anyway, even though it's a one-goal game instead of tied. It's not going to all of a sudden be a shootout, I wouldn't think.
Canada's got it in their own zone. The Flyers take possession in the defensive end. Moves the puck. Jaquizi's gonna play it from the back of the cage. Great read with the stick. And he's going after him here.
Tucker's looking around for somebody to fight. He's gonna have to go and fill the dance card somewhere else. Matthews is even
all alone! Penalty has expired. Both sides back to even strength. Grand Prairie's got a hold of the puck now. Almost lost the puck, but hands on here as play continues. Slides it across. All quick work with the stick and comes up with the puck. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Sam. Gets in front of it. Canada's got a hold of it along the wall. Stays with it. Clockwork's got the puck along the wall. Referee Shilovec's hand is in the air. We got a penalty coming up. There's the whistle, and here's the call.
A penalty puts the whole bench in a little bit of uneasiness. They got a one-goal lead, but they're shorthanded.
Canada's man advantage unit will take to the ice for the first time tonight.
This power play almost jumped off the bench as soon as the penalty was called. They want out. They think they're the end.
Welcome to the league.
Trying to clear the puck. And it's a small victory for the PK unit here.
Well, it's their job. Get it down the ice. Get off the ice. Get some new people out there.
Canada's got the puck in the defensive end. Knocked away in the offensive zone. Grand Prairie's gained possession along the boards. Puck scooped up by Perron. Slides it back to the blue line.
Perron's got the puck now. He had to go ahead goal early.
Tried to get 2Q with it and loses possession.
Perron's got the green light to try this move almost anywhere on the ice. The coaches have great faith. Really good play to score and to get this game back to even. Now we'll see who can grab momentum. Time and again in practice. Sure, there's no goalies in there because who wants to volunteer for this? But this is a missile. The one-timer blows right by the goaltender.
Second period nearly into its final minute here. Dumps it into the O zone. Grand Prairie's got possession of the puck. Moving into the attacking zone. Can finish. Oh,
it really is. I mean, the play is sitting right there. There's a scoring chance to be had. They just don't execute it.
And with that, two periods now in the books. Been a great night of hockey here on EA Sports, and we got the third period coming at you in moments. Here we go, a big third period set to go. Ray Ferraro, James Cebulski bringing you all the action. Well, let's see what this third period can offer in what has been a scorefest thus far. Clockwork's got the puck along the wall. Tucker's been brought down, and we're going to get a penalty here. And let's see what the call is.
The tripping call is made, and now the penalty killers are going to have to get to work as he heads to the box.
Time for the power play unit to get back to work.
Power plays go up and down. That's just the way they are. But when you haven't been successful, you've got to reload, refocus, and get to work on that next one.
Sends it over to Tucker. Marchand stick handling in his own zone. And they clear that puck. They gain possession here inside the neutral zone. Looks to make a play over to Matthews.
Welcome to the league.
Officials are calling. The Flyers will serve two for slashing. Clockwork's got another opportunity here on the man advantage.
Their power play hasn't been able to score yet. I think what's available, James, is the cross crease. The one-time play is there.
Puck exits the zone. On the attack along the boards. Grand Prairie's got possession while under man. There's a hit on the play.
Directions on you.
Tucker's ready for the draw on this man advantage. The Flyers take possession off the faceoff. Here's an opportunity to get the puck out of their own end. And a nice job by the Killers on that one.
Yeah, now they can get a change, get some fresh players on the ice.
And the power play comes up empty. Both teams back to even strength.
That power play was a lot of window dressing. They had the puck in the offensive zone, but really didn't.
Off the outside of the iron!
Oh, that's so close. I love the chance on goal, but it hits the post, and the game remains tied.
Score! That's three!
I have nine of these games. It is such a cool thing to score three. You feel so good about yourself. Looked like it was just about perfect, didn't it? He doesn't even react as this puck goes by him.
Grand Prairie's got the lead here in the third. I'm almost surprised it's not more.
They can almost exhale a little bit. You always worry when you control possession and the game stays tied that the other guys are going to get a lucky one. But they're in front now.
This is just up and over. Flailing at him with a stick to try to get control. Grand Prairie's got it behind the net. Here's a chance on the doorstep. Center along the wing. The Flyers played along the boards. And they'll be forced to tag up after that missed pass. And that's some great pressure in the offensive end by Matthews. Simple stop by Murphy. Moves it to Perron. Grand Prairie's got a hold of it against the wall. Canada's looking to break out of their own end. Perron's got the puck in his own zone. They got a pair on a 2-on-1. Oh, Smart has that play to put that one away. And that's broken up with a stick in front. The Flyers have it behind the cage. Canada's got the puck behind the net. And they get that puck down the ice. Great poke check on the reach. Clockwork's got the puck along the boards. And out of the up.
allowing both teams to catch their breath here and regroup. Late goings of this period. Grand Prairie's got a one-goal lead here. They're up 4-3. Hurrah's one possession.
Oh! What's Hurrah looking for in that? Thesaurus.
Oh, you got it.
Truculent?
Yeah, I know you were ready to fire that up. That is a big hit. And I knew you were digging for that one.
Both teams are set. They're ready to drop the puck. Grand Prairie's got it, and they're on the attack. Just wide of the net. Takes the puck into the corner of the offensive end.
He does it again!
Put that stick away, man. Is it hot? What an outstanding game. Bad luck for the goalie. Great luck for the shooter here. This is stopped about 90%. Hey, you got to stop 100% of it because now it's in the cage.
Hurrah's won it. Maintains possession.
Whoa.
He scores again.
Yeah, what a night for him. You think after three you might let down? Not him. They keep coming. This has got to be so frustrating for a goaltender. You get beat all kinds of places, but through your legs, really feels like you left something open that shouldn't have been.
Face off here in the neutral zone, and we are back underway. The Flyers have it now. Reads it perfectly and comes up with the takeaway. Poked away by Matthews. Canada's ready to go on the attack. Trying to clear the zone. It's a straight-up race for the puck. Obstruction penalty coming up. Looks like a hook here. Puck grabbed by Perron. Inside of the final minute here in the third. There's the whistle. Let's get the official decision.
Bad to work with this penalty, James. You're already a field goal behind, and now you got to just try and stay in touch with the game.
Tucker's won it off the faceoff. Grand Prairie's got it in the neutral zone. Working the puck deep inside the road end. Oh, a whole lot of truculence with that.
That hit was delivered with intent. That's not to rub somebody out of the play. That's to send a message.
Roy's going to opt for the whistle and give everybody a chance to breathe.
Sometimes you get running around and the shift gets long. This helps.
Jacquezi's the teammate where if you see him calling for the puck, you've got to get it to him. His 1T zone ability really allows him to one-time that puck and put everything he's got behind those shots. Let's see if he can get one.
Trying to shake the defender. Oh, what a defensive play. Jacquezi's moving the puck through his own zone. Another big hit.
Man, this guy has one color on his mind, and it's the other team's jersey.
There's the whistle. Well, I didn't like that after that shot after the whistle. Tension's rising.
Didn't take much to get this heated up. Marchand's not so sure about the weight class here. He says no thanks.
Puck possession so critical. Another faceoff coming up here. Final horn has sounded, bringing this one to an end.
Really dominant performance. I guess you can notice that from the way that they had the puck most of the time. But they won this very comfortably tonight.
Even the fancy stats crew would agree with this one.